Welcome to All Things Moore County, Moore County's weekly radio show, highlighting the many facets of the Sandhills. That includes real estate, lifestyles, community, and neighborhood. And now, from Four Properties, here's your host, Bill Sahadi.
Good morning, and welcome to the talk show, All Things Moore County. Dorothy, good morning. We're going to keep with our theme of the last couple of weeks. It's amazing how many similar themes we seem to hit on the show.
Yeah, they kind of come in groups, don't they?
Just a couple of weeks ago, we had the former executive director of the Weymouth Center, Abigail Dowd, on.
Yes.
And we talked about the Weymouth Center and what a rich place it had in the culture and the arts of Moore County.
Yep.
And isn't one of our themes how much Moore County offers its citizens in the arts and the cultures, and how it's been changing and growing?
Yeah.
And today, we're going to reach out a little bit, but not so far.
No, not too far.
We're going to be talking all about the Temple Theater in Sanford today. And we have a whole crew of some very dedicated and enthusiastic and passionate people.
Yes.
Led by Peggy Taphorn, who is a producing artistic director of the Temple Theater. I'm so glad that you could make the short trip down here to join us.
Thank you, Bill. As you mentioned, it is quite a short trip.
Right.
And we are very fortunate that a lot of Moore County residents come to visit us at the Temple Theater.
Right.
So I thought this morning I'd return the favor and we'd bring a group of us down to Moore County to visit you.
I want you to introduce all our guests, but before I do, I need to ask you a question. Are you a North Carolina native?
I am not.
How did you get here?
I am in my eighth season at the Temple Theater.
Okay.
It's actually a kind of a funny story. I was doing the tour of Sweet Charity. I was based in New York City for 23 years.
Okay.
And so we were touring around the country, and a friend of mine had come to interview for the artistic director job at the Temple because he was teaching at School of the Arts here in North Carolina. And my tour was going to Greenville, South Carolina. And I'm a little geographically challenged, so I thought, oh, South Carolina, North Carolina, how far can it be?
Right.
So I asked for a night off from the tour and drove from Greenville, South Carolina, which is quite a distance, by the way.
That's right.
To Sanford and interviewed for the job, saw the beautiful historic venue and just kind of fell in love, but then went back to touring with Molly Ringwald and my normal life. And they called me back for a second interview. The tour was in Baltimore, Maryland. I rented another car, drove down to Sanford, and that evening the Heart of Carolina Jazz Orchestra was playing on the stage.
Right.
They wined and dined me at the Steel Pig restaurant, and I saw the show, and literally I was hooked.
And the rest was history.
The rest was history, and I drove back to Baltimore the next day and called the company manager, gave my two-week notice, went back to New York, packed up all my stuff, bought a car.
Right.
Because in New York, you don't need a car.
Are you a New Yorker originally?
I'm originally from Belleville, Illinois.
Okay.
But once I got my degree in musical theater from Webster University Conservatory of the Arts, I moved to New York and spent more years in New York than I had in Illinois or in college, of course, hopefully. So the rest, as you said, was history, and I'm very happily ensconced now in North Carolina, much better weather than either Illinois or New York.
Running a regional theater takes a love and a passion, and our country is set up with smaller venues, not these large urban areas.
Correct.
And it takes a ton of dedication and a 24/7 mentality, doesn't it?
That's right. My friends from New York, when they get to come down and work with me or visit, once they see the historic venue, they know why I'm in North Carolina. But I continue to tell them I've never worked harder.
Right.
And I had a pretty decent career in New York. But this is, it, like you said, it's 24/7. And we rely a lot on the kindness of strangers, on our donors and patrons and volunteers to make our Broadway-caliber musicals happen. So I'm really thankful for this opportunity to bring this kind of talent and this kind of production to Sanford and our area.
You guys are at the right place at the right time because the demographics of this country are changing.
Mm-hmm.
People are moving. They're gravitating south. They're moving for lifestyle. They're moving for a better tax base, just a better life experience. And yet that micropolitan nature of our area is what we're trying very hard to be all things to all people, but still
right.
retain the small town charm.
Well, and that's where, when I accepted this job, I thought at that point it was a good fit, and I found out that it is a good fit because I was raised in a small town in Illinois, but then moved to New York City, so obviously a very urban area. So I have the mindset of both a small business owner in a small town and living in an urban area. And that's kind of the mix of our demographic these days in Sanford, and you were talking about Moore County in particular.
Right.
There are a lot of people who grew up here, and there are a lot of relocated Yankees.
That's right.
So I sort of get both mindsets and want to keep our authenticity, keep our small-town flavor, while still being welcoming and open and bringing the big city experiences that we all have become accustomed to, you know, fine dining as well as fine entertainment, but maintaining our beautiful historic venues and our hometown feel.
And the Temple Theater has a lot to offer just coming up this fall season, and a different demographic that you're also reaching out to.
Exactly. You and I had spoken briefly when I first got here in 2007 that we had quite a few patrons. A big percentage of our season ticket holders in particular were
right.
from Moore County.
Right.
That has lessened a little bit in the past couple of years. Part of that's systemic. People don't want to plan a full year in advance like they used to.
Mm-hmm.
So it's across the boards in America. Season ticket sales for theaters are down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also the new demographic.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have to get the word out a little harder. And now, this year in particular, we're instigating another matinee because we have found that our drivers from, you know, further out, a 45-minute to an hour drive, don't want to drive later in the evenings anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a big part of our season ticket base.
Mm-hmm.
So now we've added, now we're not only doing Thursday matinees at 2 p.m., but we're also doing Friday matinees at 2 p.m., in addition to our regular Sunday matinees at 2 p.m. So we're giving people different opportunities to come in and experience the Temple Theater where you don't have to drive in the evenings. And we're hoping to capture some of that more audience back.
You've got you've assembled quite a crew here today.
Yes, I brought the A-team with me.
And the A-team, and I'm going to step back and let you introduce everybody, but did you notice how she said, we thought North Carolina and South Carolina were so close to each other? New Yorkers are so provincial, they think New Brunswick, New Jersey is Mars. They
exactly.
think Baltimore, Maryland is the Deep South. and they think Alabama is just not in this universe. They're so provincial.
That's right.
Please introduce, you have a distinguished group of guests here.
Absolutely. I'll start with Chris deLambert, who is a Temple Theater employee. He is our marketing and development director. He's been a wonderful addition to our marketing team. You know, these days marketing is difficult because
right.
you have to use a lot of different media, and Chris is an expert at that. So I'm going to let him say hello, and then I'll
yeah.
go down the line.
Well, hello.
The world is, she's right, the world is a challenging place. How do you get your message out these days?
Every mechanism we can employ.
Right.
I mean, the biggest challenge, I think, is using enough imagination to come out and make sure that we're saturating the airwaves and print media and everything the best that we can.
Right.
There's nothing more heartbreaking than when we have folks, you know, from Lee or the surrounding counties who, you know, find out after we did something, like, oh, I didn't know. Well, you know, what else can we do to get the word out there? So it's a constant challenge. It's busy. I have no theatrical background at all. I'm a retired soldier. Peggy put up a listing for the job. My wife was tired of me hanging around the house and sent me to see her. And I remember sitting for about half an hour listening to Peggy talk, thinking about ways I could tell her no.
Yeah.
And
has she always been so shy?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Well, that's what got me. But she asked me at the end of the interview, she said, well, let's go next door and see the theater. And
uh-huh.
I'd never been in the temple before. I'd just moved to the area.
Right.
And we walked through the doors, and I looked around, and I stopped her, and I said, I don't care what you can pay me. You have to hire me. And about half an hour later, she did, and I've been there ever since. It's been a lot of fun. And to watch, you know, she hit on the downtown and the historic nature of downtown Sanford and the temple. But folks from around the rest of the region are not aware of what we've got going on in the downtown right now. And we passed an $8.5 million bond issue a couple years ago, and those projects have just kicked in. So the sidewalks are being replaced. The utilities are coming down. There's new greenery going in throughout the downtown. And if you were to drive down there today, you'd say, wow, what a mess. But pardon our progress. We're about 90 days away from really, really having a showpiece as a downtown. And the temple really is the crown jewel in that. We're right smack dab in the middle of downtown.
Right.
And we're excited about everything that's going on.
Right. Right. You have other guests here
yes,
as well?
Yes, I do. I also brought some of the fabulous talent. One of our challenges also at the Temple Theater is letting people know that we are a professional theater and that we bring in talent from all over North Carolina as well as local talent and as far away as New York City and Chicago and L.A. And I know people are always astonished when they see the shows, the caliber of talent we get.
Right.
So I brought a mixture for you. I have Janee Cates, who is a Southern Pines resident. So, Janee, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
And who do you play in My Fair Lady?
I am a member of the ensemble, and I am Mrs. Einsford Hill, Freddie's mother.
And how many shows have you done with us?
This is my fourth show at the Temple.
How long have you lived in Southern Pines?
24 years.
Have you really?
Yes. Yes.
And we're kind of like neighbors, almost.
We are.
Right?
We are.
Same neck of the woods.
Yes.
I drive by your house every day going down Indiana
Avenue.
Can I say that?
Of course.
Are you a native?
I'm not. I'm from Tennessee originally.
How'd you get to Moore County?
My husband. After we got married, we moved here from the mountains, and he had a small family business in Robeson County, and we preferred to live in Moore County, so...
Right.
We've been here ever since.
Yeah, and the trek to Sanford is not even a trek, is it?
It's
18 to it's a 20
it's
minute.
About, it takes me 25 minutes to get from my driveway to the theater.
Right.
And Janee was someone people are always also asking, how did they get involved at the Temple? Well, on the talent end, we do season auditions in the spring each year. So at the end of last season, we saw about 140 people. And I really do try to hire locally as much as possible because we are a regional theater. And to be a good regional theater, I think we should give the local talent a shot. And
right.
North Carolina is chock full of talent.
Right.
I'm always amazed at the caliber of people that come out. So that's how I first discovered Janee. And then, as she said, now, you know, once I get my hook in you, then you just keep coming back.
It's an addiction.
Well, it's welcome to the table. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Next, we have Haley Bess Jernigan. This is her first time at the Temple.
It is.
Haley and I actually met in Moore County. We were judges for our mutual friend, Shannon Shepherd's voice students. And we got to talking. I had seen Haley perform before. And we talked about this upcoming season, and I just thought she would be a perfect Eliza in My Fair Lady. So now that I've totally given away everything about you.
I have nothing else to
yes.
say.
Welcome, Haley.
Thank you.
Talk a little bit.
This is my first show at the Temple, and I have been to Sanford a couple times, but honestly didn't even know the Temple existed until Peggy. So I had worked at other theaters in North Carolina and New York and around the country, but when I met Peggy, and she told me about this theater that she ran. I was like, hey, we should work together. And then she mentioned, well, we might possibly do My Fair Lady, so you should maybe possibly audition for that.
Really?
And so we got together and made that happen, and here I am. So it's been an amazing experience so far. Super, super fun.
So you don't occur to me that you possibly could have a whole lot of experience, but you obviously do. You're so young.
Well, I started performing... a long time ago. My first show, I think I was like 5 or 6, but the first professional show I did, I was 7, and did Oliver, and after that did Annie, and then kind of just found all of these children's roles that I could do in North Carolina and get paid for it, and that was kind of awesome as a child. And then in the summers in high school, I would travel and do a show for the summer and then come back to school.
High school for you?
I'm from Goldsboro, so I started at Eastern Wayne High School there, but then I moved to North Carolina School of the Arts to finish high school and study opera there, so had a lot of performance opportunities there as well.
And this is your first performance at the Temple?
It is, and I'm thrilled.
We're going to talk more about the show itself.
Right.
Want to introduce one more guest?
Absolutely. I brought in from New York one of my
I can tell
dearest
from New York.
Friends. His name is Jacob Toth, and I'm not even sure how many collaborations we've done. But anytime I can hire Jacob away from all the other theaters that want to use him, and cruise ships, and circuses, and any other kind of entertainment, I do. And it's... Again, it's a privilege to be able to bring this caliber of talent to work with our professionals and our kids at the Temple Theater. It's one of the experiences that I think is rare and unique to the Temple, is that Jacob and I don't hold back. We treat everyone at the Temple as if we're doing a New York show. And Jacob is great at that, and he is choreographing this, although he is a director as well. So, hello, Jacob. Talk.
Hello, Peggy. I think this is actually our fifth production here at the Temple Theater together, but we've worked many places outside of the Temple Theater together as well.
Okay.
And Peggy's very right. I bring down choreography that I've taught on Broadway, and I don't dumb it down. I make these people kick their faces and fall down to the floor and get it going. So it's a lot of fun.
Are the challenges of working regional theater versus in New York, is it different? Is it?
It's really not. In fact, it's kind of easier to work regionally because there's so much more work to be had.
Right.
When everyone is in New York, you know, there's only 12 Broadway theaters, so there's only 12 opportunities for us where there's a whole country out here where we can go and work. So, you know, sure, there are challenges with size of stages maybe, or I'm not going to say limited on talent because there's amazing talent down here in North Carolina. And
right.
I found a lot of talent all over the country. So,
and being from New York, don't you find that there's another whole world out there besides the city?
There is.
A big
it's
world.
Amazing.
Except if you're in New York, people think we don't
there's
count.
Nothing else, exactly.
But we do.
But luckily, I'm not a native New Yorker either. I grew up in a small town called Oregon, Ohio. And like Peggy, I've traveled this country a lot. So we know that there is life outside of big Manhattan.
We're going to come back in the second set. We're going to talk a lot about your fall programs. I want to talk a little bit about the history of the theater. And just to comment that so many people in our area, whenever they go to the Temple Theater, they come back, and what do? They talk. Word of mouth. And Chris, I mean, that used to be the old marketing, word of mouth. If you just put on a good product and did a good job, the world would flock to your door. Today, the world needs to be educated to flock to your door.
Although I have to say, Bill, that word of mouth is still our biggest marketing tool.
It's actually measurable, and we can see it in attendance trends with every single thing that we do.
Mm-hmm.
And that first weekend is the most critical for us because, you know, in these rural communities, folks do talk. And there's an awful lot of folks don't want to be the first one through the door. So, you know, we put our best foot forward for those first weeks. It's a little frustrating, though, because how many times, you know, we haven't had a bad show in a long time. And,
exactly.
and you know, attendance numbers always pick up in the second and third weeks. And, it's a little frustrating. But we see the word of mouth, and we recognize how important it is. And we do, you know, we do an awful lot of things to try to get people there early so they can help us spread the word.
Great. We're going to come back. We're talking about the Temple Theater all day today. It's a great organization, providing a lot of the arts and the culture to Moore County. This is All Things Moore County.
One enormous chair, how wouldn't it be lovely? Lots of chocolate for me to eat. Lots of cow mic and lots of eat. Warm face, warm hands, warm feet, how wouldn't it be lovely? Oh, so lovely, sitting absolutely still. I would never.
I'm an ordinary man who desires nothing more than just an ordinary chance to live exactly as he likes and do precisely what he wants. An average man am I.
We're back in our second set. We're talking all about the Temple Theater today. And Peggy, is this the time of the year that you're moving forward into your heavy production season, your performances, what's coming up, all the upcoming events?
Yes, absolutely. We are kicking off our 2015-2016 season. So season tickets are on sale now, and they're only available through the month of September. And you do, there's a significant savings per ticket, so it really is kind of the way to go. And something interesting about the Temple Theater is that we sell a 4-pass and a 7-pass, but they're flexible. So we have some people who will buy a 4-pass and use them all for our Christmas production, or buy a 7-pass because they know they've got a big family coming in, and they'll use it all for, say, My Fair Lady, because everybody's coming in for the fall kickoff. So that's one of the wonderful things about our season ticket sales. Our season actually kicks off in the summer with our youth programs, and that's one of the things I'm most proud of. Since getting here in 2007, our youth programs have expanded exponentially every year, but at least by about 50%. We kicked off this summer with productions of The Little Mermaid, in which we had 48 kids participating in two different three-week conservatories that culminate in a main stage musical, which was fantastic. And we did have youth from Moore County involved in that. And then we also did, new this year, as part of our youth programming, a production of The Tempest, which was our first youth Shakespeare in the Depot Park area. And that was also very well received. So we kick off the season with our youth programs in the summer, and then we head right into our main stage season. This year, we are starting with the classic, as we've mentioned, My Fair Lady,
mm-hmm.
Which is sort of our, we do have a little bit of a formula going on. We like to kick off with a big, splashy, recognizable Broadway musical, and I certainly think everybody knows My Fair Lady. And if they don't, they should come experience it for the first time. It's one of those that is timeless. It has beautiful music, but more importantly, it has a great storyline. And the book scenes, I think, in this one are the longest book scenes of any musical I've ever directed. Mm-hmm. And you really do get to the heart of these characters, and there's a lot of meat in there. And you get to see the transformation of Haley's character, Eliza, which is always
right.
Wonderful.
She made a face.
She made a face.
I caught it.
So I'll just rattle off the rest of our season, since
I think
I've mentioned season tickets are on sale now. We're following that. In the Halloween time, we try to do something spooky and ooky, and this year we're doing The Addams Family, the musical, which is fits right into that.
Mm-hmm.
And then due to popular demand, we had a musical version of A Christmas Carol that has been written specifically for the Temple Theater. And as you mentioned, it is a historic venue. It's beautiful. And this production fits right in there. And that will be running again this year. We've taken about a four-year hiatus from producing it. And now, due to popular demand, we're bringing that one back. This year it's going to be new in that I have cast two different sets of 20 youth, which will alternate performances. So there's going to be a cast of over 40 people, and half of those will be young people under the age of 18 this year. In January, we're bringing in a wonderful drama called Doubt, and I actually have one of the stars of the movie version of Doubt is coming down to star in that. Michael Puzo is his name. And then following that, another due to popular demand, we are bringing back one of the Temple favorites, Jason Petty, who's going to star in his Hank Williams show. He played Hank Williams on Broadway. He played him in the Ryan Theater in Nashville. And he's coming to little old Sanford to do Hank Williams. His show is called Hank and My Honky Tonk Heroes. He brings a six-piece band with him. It's fantastic. Then we're doing a really crazy comedy called Always a Bridesmaid, which was written by the authors of The Golden Girls. We had a big success with their Dixie Swim Club 2 years ago.
Uh-huh.
And again, people have said, when are you going to bring back those Golden Girls writers? So they're coming back in Always a Bridesmaid. And then we are ending our 32nd season. We've been doing the Sanders Family trilogy the last couple of seasons, which has been a huge hit. Again, seven very musically inclined performers. They play a variety of instruments. Each performer plays at least two instruments, if not multiples of that. And this is the third in the trilogy, the final, and it's called The Sanders Family Smoke on the Mountain Homecoming.
It's an aggressive schedule.
Absolutely. We never stop.
No, it's really an aggressive schedule.
Oh, I know what you mean.
people don't understand how much work goes into a production.
That's right.
And then you go from one to the other, and you have to start all over.
A lot of them, all of them overlap
in
production.
Sleep?
No.
Yeah.
Once we hit about July,
yeah,
we don't stop until mid-May when the season ends. Then we take about a five-day breather, and then we crank it up again for our summer to start with all the kids.
And after
Chris,
after the first weekend of My Fair Lady on that Monday, I think that it'll be a ghost town at the theater for about 3 days until we get ready for the second weekend.
And then you reach
it's home. Just, I mean, it's fever pitch right now. The summer's crazy, and then we just ramp it up. And, you know, I told you I didn't have any theatrical background coming into this. This season kind of brings it full circle for me because Jason Petty was last year 4 years ago, and they hired me on the Monday after Jason closed his last show. So now I'll have seen everything, I guess. That's kind of how I feel about it. But, you know, I didn't have the respect for what all of these folks sitting here with me do.
Right.
You know, I came in and thought, oh, theater, yeah, it's cool. Yeah, we can, you know, yeah. Kick my feet back and, you know, run an ad or two every once in a while, play around on Facebook. This is going to be awesome. It's exactly the opposite of that, but right. It's 10 times more rewarding. And then the what theater means to different people. One of my favorite parts of this season so far was getting quotes from Haley. And I asked her for some material and said, hey, you know, tell me about, you know, how this wound up. And to listen to her talk about Eliza and what that role means to her, you know, she's, first of all, she's being bashful because she hasn't told anybody yet. Haley is 2011 Miss North Carolina. Haley is a big deal in the state of North Carolina and nationally. And to get her to come grace our beautiful theater is awesome. And I know that Peggy and I and Jacob and everybody else associated with it hopes this is the first of, you know, two or three shows a year that Haley's going to do.
Please
there.
And thank you.
But I would love for her to relate the same story that she told me about Eliza and this being her dream role. So I'll just kind of.
And by the way, the show opens September 10th.
Correct.
That's important for people to know.
That's right.
What is it about Eliza? What is it that resonates?
You know, I think I was one of those kind of romantic kids that just loved like the princess theme of movies and Disney and that whole thing. And then I kind of got into older movies and became obsessed with Audrey Hepburn. And so Sabrina was one of my favorites. And then Roman Holiday. And then I was introduced to My Fair Lady. And for some weird reason, I wanted to watch that movie every single day and could literally quote every single line in that movie, which I have since forgotten.
I am now relearning
my lines. But I was so obsessed with that movie, and I think it's because Audrey Hepburn was something different than what I had ever seen her as before. She wasn't beautiful from the start. She wasn't glamorous from the very beginning. And she had this transformation that I just completely fell in love with, plus the music. And so then later, as I was taking voice lessons as a young child, I sang a few of the songs from the show, Just You Wait, and I Could Have Danced All Night, and Wouldn't It Be Loverly? And so now it's kind of come full circle, and I've always wanted to play Eliza. But not many theaters around here especially have done this show since I've been old enough to be Eliza. So I thought that chance was never going to happen. I was just never going to get to be Eliza, and that was the end of that. And there were just certain dream roles that I wanted, and one was Cinderella, and, you know, I got to do that and whatever. But this is one that I've always dreamt of doing. And so as soon as Peggy said something about it last year, I was like, yes.
She started stalking me.
I did. I stalked her. I literally started sending her emails, like, every month, like, have you announced your season? Are you doing My Fair Lady yet? She mentioned a couple other shows, and I was like, please just go with My Fair Lady. And so she did. And so when she finally sent me that email, I'm like, praise the Lord, this is my chance.
I have to ask you a question because Peggy brought up something that you did this summer for the kids. And when you put the theater out there for kids, you create indelible impressions that hopefully as they get older, they'll always respect the arts, whether they take part or not. Tell me about your parents.
My dad is a classically trained pianist and organist.
What a surprise.
And has played professionally for years.
Okay.
My mom is a great audience member. And she has helped with wigs and makeup before in some local productions that I've done, but she's not really a performer. Okay. She would agree with me. But my brother actually is a performer as well. He's not really in it as much anymore, but has a beautiful voice. So we're a very musical family and always have been.
And you got a lot of support from your family.
Absolutely.
Obviously.
Very much so.
Mm-hmm. It's unusual to someone your age to go back to the classics.
They're my favorite. I mean, wow. I've done a lot of the more contemporary shows, which are fun, but I think there's just something about the classics that appeal to all different age groups, and it's not just older people. I mean, a lot of my friends are like, you're doing My Fair Lady? That's one of my favorite movies. I have to go see it. And so even if they associate it with the movie, I think if we can ever get them in the doors to see it live on stage,
right.
Their lives are just going to be changed because the classics are the best, in my opinion. But I grew up doing theater in a theater very similar to the Temple in Goldsboro. We have kind of the same downtown scenario with the theater being the centerpiece for that. And so at the Paramount, we did a lot of the classics, and that's what I was kind of used to and what I grew up with. So this is kind of like going home, but better.
So
hopefully it will be your new home.
Hopefully.
It's been delayed.
I think I sense that the recruiter in you is omnipresent.
Absolutely. Well, and I think Haley just hit on something great that I'm going to have Jacob expound on a little bit. In the classics, you really do you have everything and something for everyone.
Uh-huh.
You know, a lot of people know the music and they know Audrey Hepburn, mm-hmm. but there's a whole other element of the dance element as well as the humor element mm-hmm. that sometimes is lacking in contemporary musicals, I find. And for myself as an audience member, I want to go to theater to be moved and to be educated and to be enlightened, but also to enjoy myself. And so there are so many elements of My Fair Lady that you just sit there. Mm-hmm. And Jacob and I have now seen it for, you know, 2 weeks straight. And I still laugh out loud at some of the antics and some of the dance and some of the jokes. And that's enjoyable to me. That's what I want.
We're gonna come back and open up with Jacob in the third set. We want to hear from you.
Excellent.
We're talking about the Temple Theater. This is All Things Mark Kenny. We'll be right back.
Street before, but the pavement always stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live.
We don't have enough. We're back for our third set. We don't have enough time, I don't think, today. 1 hour is not.
We need another hour.
Yeah, it's not going to cover. I can see that. And everybody has so much they want to say. We want to talk to Jacob. We want to talk to Janee.
Janee. And
get a perspective from you as well. We want to personalize you guys.
Absolutely.
So even though you're not from New York, you're from Ohio.
That's true.
But now you're in North Carolina.
Yep.
And you are you here full time?
No, I just come down when Peggy calls and tells me she needs me. Then I'm on the plane down.
So. It's one of the other elements that people don't realize is that we bring in creative talent. Our lighting designer's from New York. Jacob, obviously, is from New York. We have various people that come in. All of our productions are homegrown, except for the Jason Petty, which he's bringing his band from Nashville. But 99% of our shows, we do the costumes, we do the lights, we do the set design, we do bring in the creative team, and for, you know, a three-week rehearsal process, we put on these major, extravagant experiences, and then the shows run for 3 weeks, and then everybody goes home.
Yeah.
And we start all over again.
It's true. And this particular production, My Fair Lady, is a different one for us in particular because it has so many elements in it. There's some great acting in it because, like Peggy was saying, it's one of the musicals that has the most book scenes in it. Musicals aren't known for that.
Right.
And then it's not necessarily known as a dance show, but there's some amazing dance numbers in the show. The Ascot Gavotte in particular is such a fun number mm-hmm. to work on and such a beautiful number to see on stage. So that's a lot of fun. And then all the numbers in it that Haley singing, that Mark, who's playing Doolittle, is singing. There's just some great, fun songs. So this has a little bit of everything for everyone, which musicals don't always have. Sometimes, you know, musicals are really dance-based, and you want to go see the dancing in it, or you want to go hear the great songs. This has everything, so mm-hmm. it should appeal to everyone.
Mm-hmm. Janee, you have done musicals before.
I have. Mm-hmm.
My Fair Lady is a special. Have you ever done My Fair Lady?
I have not done My Fair Lady.
Okay.
Lots of Rodgers and Hammerstein, you know, your classics, but not My Fair Lady.
Okay.
But love, 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 love doing them. I mean, that is my joy in life.
Like
besides my children and my husband, of course.
And you don't have to travel. That's what's so nice.
That's exactly right.
You don't have to be on the road. You're right here.
And you spoke a little bit briefly about the narcissism of New Yorkers, of which I was one for 23 years.
Me too.
Yeah, exactly. But I think one of the great things is, as that we've hit on briefly, is that the talent pool in North Carolina is so deep.
Right.
And not everybody wants to live in New York. New York is a difficult place in which to function. And one of my joys is to be able to hire what I consider local people to do these great, really Broadway caliber shows while they can still raise their families and have a decent quality of life. It's one of our joys at the Temple Theater is to combine all the elements that makes the arts come to life. And, of course, when you have local people in the show, they also bring their family and their parents and their church clubs and their civic groups, and, right. and that certainly helps on the business end as well. But a lot of it is that I can because the talent pool runs so deep here.
Talk to me a little bit about the business end. You mentioned season ticket sales.
Correct.
For September. You have a four pass and a seven pass.
And a seven pass. And there's a lot more information on our website, which is www.templeshows.com. Again, it's templeshows.com. Or you can join us on Facebook. We are always trying to get more likes on the Facebook at the Temple Theater Company. Or you can call Anna in the box office. She is happy to sell you single tickets, season tickets, whatever you desire.
Okay.
And that number is 919-774-4155.
Okay. Tell me very briefly about Greta.
Greta is our director of education. She is also a Midwestern transplant who has worked extensively in the Charlotte area at Charlotte Children's Theater.
Okay.
And I lured her away from that. Last season was her first season with us at the Temple, and this is her second season, and she's been an integral part of expanding our youth programs. For the first time last season, as well as the Shakespeare in Depot Park, we did a school tour where we hired professional actors to go out into the schools, and I know she's planning that for this upcoming spring, late winter, early spring, and we will come into Moore County if schools want to have our productions there for a nominal fee. You know, it's literally about a quarter of what the other touring companies in the area have been charging. And part of our goal, too, is to bring quality, affordable arts appreciation and entertainment to people of all ages. And Greta's a big part of that.
It's a challenge to do it affordably. The expense of these productions. Very quick, I'll just back off. After 9/11, I brought a singer here from New York. Her name was Jane Oliver. She was a singer who sang with Johnny Mathis. Mm-hmm. She was a favorite of mine. I didn't know her. I picked up the phone call. She said she'd come. I needed like 3 months of therapy after the one-night concert. I was shaking. I had no clue. The expense, you know, I just started going into my pocket. It was a benefit. It was a one-night, and I still haven't recovered, and it was...
Right.
14 years ago.
Well, part of the thing about doing theater as well that a lot of your listeners may or may not know is that a lot of our expenses are upfront. You know, we've been paying creative team. We've been paying actors. We've spent at least probably close to $6,000 on costumes alone, and that's before any performance. So, and it's not like being a shoe salesman where you can have an after Christmas sale or a Labor Day sale. For us, if our seats are left unsold, that's a once-in-a-lifetime experience that has passed. So in conjunction with season ticket sales, of course, we're always seeking sponsors for our shows and donations and doing fundraisers. So I'm going to segue to Chris because opening weekend, it's not enough that we opened our biggest, splashiest musical of the year, but the day after opening on September 12th, Saturday, Chris is spearheading a brand new fundraiser for us, which we hope will bring lots of people from Moore County up to Sanford to experience what we are calling Sounds on Steele.
And I am an empathetic guy, and I heard your story about the time when you brought one singer down, and it took 3 months to recover.
3 years.
So what I decided to do with this Sounds on Steele Festival was book 14 acts.
Oh, geez.
From all over the country to come in for this thing. This is a vision that started probably the day I started at the Temple 4 years ago. And, you know, it really kind of kicked off with as part of a conversation with Tommy Edwards, who most folks that are bluegrass fans know around here.
Right.
And I said, hey, I got an idea. And, you know, had Tommy turned and walked away from me, it probably would have been the end of it. But he sat down and he said, that's a great idea. So what we decided to do was put together a music festival. And
oh my.
We figured the geography of Sanford is as good as it is anywhere.
Right.
We love the downtown, and especially with the direction it's headed right now. And, you know, why not? So the Sounds on Steele Festival is an eight-hour festival in Sanford, right in the middle of downtown. There's two outdoor stages. One will be across the street from the temple in the parking lot there. We're bringing in a 24-foot stage, back line, and everything else that goes with. And the second will be on the permanent stage that's over in Depot Park that a lot of people are familiar with.
Right.
Our headliners that will be on the Carthage Street stage across from the temple are the Darlins from the Andy Griffith Show. And every North Carolinian worth their salt
right. Grew
up with the Darlins. That actually is Rodney Dillard and the Dillard Band. They call themselves the Dillards now, but the Dillards will be in Sanford on September 12th. They go on at 4 o'clock. Leading up to that, you've got Three Jack Jenny, Samantha Casey and Bluegrass Jam, Sweet Potato Pie, Tommy Edwards and the Bluegrass Experience, and Sideline out of Raleigh. Those are the bluegrass bands that'll be in Sanford that day.
Right.
On the second stage, we've got an eclectic mix of everything from rap down through to country, with a little bit of everything else sprinkled in there in the middle. We've got a handful of local Lee County type acts. We've got some acts from the Triangle. It's a great mix, and there's a lot of talented young kids. It's a great chance for them to showcase. And we were able, over the course of putting this together, to break down a bit of a wall in Sanford. And the city, in advance of this festival, has actually changed their alcohol ordinances. And for the first time ever, in the streets of downtown Sanford, we will be selling beer, and open containers will be allowed for the day of the festival.
Uh-huh.
So we've got two beer vendors that will be out there the day of. We've got plenty of food vendors. There'll be all kinds of market-type vendors that'll be there as well. We're closing down three streets in the downtown. We're closing off the park, and all of that for a $20 ticket.
Sounds like a multitasking project on steroids.
That's an apt description.
It really does.
And I tell you what, this was a heck of an idea,
uh-huh.
but I will rest well once it is over with. Between pulling permits and keeping the artists happy and keeping the tech together and everything else, it's definitely been a learning experience. But we've gotten support from every possible corner of Lee County, whether it was sponsors, city officials, the folks that we needed to pull the permits from, the retailers downtown. Everybody in Lee County is excited, and we'd like to extend an invitation to everybody else in the surrounding area. Come on out and check this out. And I really, truly, honestly, from the bottom of my soul, believe that 4 or 5 years from now, this will be something that brings 10 or 15,000 people into Sanford.
Right.
This is a chance to see us as we you know, kick this thing off as the first annual of what we hope is a million of these on into the future. So it Sounds on Steele. It's the 12th of September. You can buy tickets through the Temple box office. So that's templeshows.com or call 774-4155. It's a $20 ticket for all day.
That's amazing.
We would love to have you guys up there. This has really, truly been a labor of love, and every nickel of proceeds go to the Temple Theater. So that's the best part about this thing, is at the end of the day, there will be a significant check, hopefully, as long as folks show up,
right.
going to the Temple, which you know, means a lot to a lot of folks.
Peggy, prior to this event, each year, did you fundraise in a different way, different types of events?
Yes, we've tried many different ways of fundraising. The people in our community and the surrounding communities are very generous. But as you know, there are many, many needy and deserving nonprofits in our area. So we've tried to do what we do best. And I think our best fundraisers have been to provide entertainment. And this is right up our alley. We do an annual golf tournament, which is very successful. We have done many other ideas. This year we're also doing a vaudeville night, which is going to be a fundraiser coming up in March. But I think this is one that's going to have some legs and some longevity, and will not only benefit the Temple monetarily, but will benefit the entire downtown just by getting all those people downtown. So.
Well, and it, you know, our fundraising never stops.
Right.
I mean, you talked earlier about the expenses that are associated with these productions that people don't see. Basically, though, the way that we look at it is everything that we do is a fundraiser.
Right.
And the way that we would most like people to support would be to buy season tickets, come out and see the shows. That's what we do best. We're better producers and performers than we are fundraisers. So come out and appreciate what we do. Of course, if you want to write a check as a gift, we'll take that
too. We'll take that too. And you're basically looking at the admin department, the
right.
fundraising, the development, the grant writers, the... Right. You know, rah-rah cheerleaders.
Right.
It's Chris and I, so we appreciate people like you helping us get the word out.
Right. Anyone can go on and like your Facebook page, and that will probably be a whole font of information for all the events you're talking about so that people can stay current.
We consistently put new content up. There's not many days that go by that there's not new content up there. We constantly give out tickets. We give away tickets there. But if you want to keep up to date and without having to generate a whole lot of effort, follow us on Facebook, and you'll see that, you know, a couple things will hit your news feed. We like to think that we keep it as updated as anybody out there. The website's a useful tool.
Yeah.
Facebook, however you want to, just keep in touch with us.
Are you guys working on a mobile app?
We yes. actually, the city of Sanford is
that was
about
a yes?
to.
Okay, good.
The city of Sanford is actually rolling out a mobile app. We will be one of the key partners in that app, so
okay.
we're excited about that.
Okay.
We looked at the legwork and the logistics with keeping an update an app and maintaining it, and with the size of staff we've got, that was just a bridge too far.
Yeah.
But just when we thought that it wasn't going to happen, the Sanford Herald announced and called us and said, hey, look, this is what we're thinking about. Would you guys be interested? And the answer was a resounding, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So that'll be coming out, and that's just another feather in our cap and for the county that we think will be a great addition.
The world is changing. You walk around, you go into a Panera, people are looking at their phones, they're staring at these little rectangles, and they're punching this and punching that, and it's amazing. And people are tech... Everybody is getting their information differently than
That's
they
right.
did traditionally, and it's not going to go back.
Right, but there is something about live theater that
yeah.
can't be replicated.
Yes.
There's nothing like live theater.
I
and
agree.
I'm going to put Janee on the spot for a minute, because as a Moore County resident, you know, there are, as you said, there are many opportunities and many options for entertainment.
Right.
And one of the things that I want to get the word out is that, A, the Temple Theater is very close to Moore County, and, B, I know Janee also comes as a patron when she's not in shows, so if you want to talk a little bit about that commute time and why it's worth it, and how our tickets are so inexpensive that and it's only halfway to the DPAC and there's no parking involved.
Exactly.
So there you go.
Well, you just said it all, Peggy.
Seriously, the commute from Southern Pines to Sanford is 25, 30 minutes tops.
If that, right.
And there is no traffic, and it is four lane the whole way. I mean, it's perfect. It really is perfect. And the caliber of shows is, if you've never been to see a Temple show, you will be blown away. I mean, it is incredible. It is a tiny stage, but oh my gosh, what Peggy can do on that tiny stage is incredible.
Right.
So please come and see a show at Temple, and you will never want to go to DPAC again.
You know, to piggyback with that is, you know, Downtown Sanford offers some things that not necessarily every place else does. You know, we have more than our fair share of locally owned restaurants that are within walking distance of the theater. And we have, sometimes I wonder, the restaurants locally will tell you that, you know, we add to them and that a lot of our patrons go there. But I know for a fact there are a handful of those restaurants. Those folks come more for the food, I think, sometimes than do the theater. But no, I mean, from the Steel Pig, Cafe 121, La Dolce Vita,
mm-hmm.
Just on and on and on. Within a block and a half of the theater, these amazing, amazing restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
What I will tell folks out there, if they're considering coming to town, they do a little bit of research. If you're coming in, you want to eat on show night, call and get reservations, because you
right.
you might get your heart broken if you don't.
Right.
But it's an amazing experience to come out there, and the work that's going on now with the sidewalks going down, the utilities coming down. You know, we really think that we can provide a complete experience for folks that come out and spend a night with us at the Temple.
Yep.
And it's amazing, as I listen to these guys talk about, you know, this being a classic and, you know, this is a historical show. it's amazing, and I know Peggy didn't even realize it as she was selecting the season. There's all that energy that goes into it. But when she came out and she gave me the first draft, I think we both assumed, oh, must have done My Fair Lady 7 or 8 years ago. They probably did it the year before she got here. And then when we peeled it back and realized My Fair Lady in the 32 years of Temple Theater had never been done,
yeah,
it just seemed like, wow, you know, it was time.
Yeah.
And so, Haley, you'll be the first Eliza ever.
No pressure.
Since 1925, wow, when the theater was built. So how you feel?
Very excited. And a little nervous now. No, I'm really excited.
The timing of having you on was great. Your opening night is just a couple of days away. Your benefit is next weekend. And people need to just go to Facebook. We're going to distribute some of your brochures. Try to give you as strong a presence in Moore County as we can. I'm sure you have. I've heard your name many times here driving around, so I know you know a lot of people. I think of Marva Kirk, of Kirk Tours. I think of ways to make the drive, you know, very painless because it's so quick, to get more people and to get the younger demographic as well.
Absolutely.
And I, Peggy, I think what you guys are doing is great.
Thank you.
And I hope that this year brings a lot of new faces, new subscribers, new patrons, as you say.
Mm-hmm.
And you should all be commended because when you do something that you're passionate about, you're not just doing it. It's not about the money. It's about the art.
Well, that's for sure.
But it is. And
yes, it is.
And it also gives you a chance to mentor others.
That's right.
Which is huge. And as Eliza, you're realizing a childhood dream.
Absolutely.
And it all started when you were younger, and that's right. The opportunity you have to. If you can touch some of the kids today, you'll leave that great impression on them.
And like you know, we were briefly talking about before, I think one of the special things and the reason that I came to North Carolina and stay in North Carolina is that we can use the local talent, and it is a locally produced product, which I think is very important to add to our everyday experience when we have so many entertainment options these days.
Well, and Peggy, what she's able to do with her hands, whether she's just the producing artistic director, if she's directing, whatever, but the question I have to answer most is people that come in and they ask, well, where's this show going to be next? Because they assume it's a touring production.
Right.
And what happens in the 3 weeks before the show opens when and my favorite day of the season is the 7 first days of rehearsal after in the next morning when Peggy comes in, because I can tell by looking at her, is this one going to be easy? Is this one going to be hard? Where are we going with this? But, you know, in 3 weeks, they throw this thing together, and it is unbelievable, the quality of production.
Chris, thank you so much for coming in. Best of luck with the fundraiser, and then I'll get you a therapist when it's over.
Sounds good.
Janee Cates, it was a pleasure. And now when I drive by, I'll know where you are.
Honk and wave.
And Haley, best of luck with the opening.
Thank you.
And it should be quite an experience for you.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure. Jacob, it was
very
a pleasure.
Nice to meet you.
Yes, sir. And I wish you guys all the best. And last but not least, Peggy Taphorn.
Thank you so much for having us. We really appreciate it.
It was a pleasure. Temple Theater is something everyone in Moore County needs to get to know. And they can start next week, starting September the 10th, with the opening production of My Fair Lady. It's a jewel in our area, and hopefully people will take advantage of what's right at their doorstep. Everybody, have a great week. This is All Things Moore County.
There'll be spring every year without you. England still will be here without you. There'll be fruit on the tree and a shore by the sea. There'll be crumpets and tea without you.